The following dramatization was inspired by actual events. Certain characters, dialogue, and events have been created for dramatic purposes.
Just real gentle. Don't pull too much. There you go.
Mom, can I have some high heels too?
No way. All right.
Ow!
Oh, honey, you got a tangle? Do it real gentle. Oh, I hate that. Better?
Mom, can I have a little lipstick?
Sure. How about bright purple?
Here, have a little bit of this.
Okay, now wait, I'm gonna put some on too. Watch me. Now mush. Perfect.
Come on, David, buddy, you're killing me here. Come on, let's go. You're not even dressed. Darn, what pants am I wearing with this shirt?
Why do we have to go to a boring farm picnic anyway?
That's a very good question. Honey, why do we have to go to a boring farmer picnic?
Can I have some of your perfume?
It's going to be a lot of fun, you guys.
Not.
Let's hurry up. Come on.
Go get dressed, okay? Now, you guys, listen. These folks around here take their 4th of July very seriously, all right? So no surfwear, no punk, no visible tattoos, no pink hair, no nose rings.
How about leather?
Why not? The locals already think we're pretty weird.
No, Sarah, that's not true. When are you going to start giving this place a chance?
How about this? Or is it too conservative?
It works for me, darling.
I thought you said we were going to be late for the picnic.
Bummer.
Wait. You're not that late.
Come on, guys.
We made a tofu burger for you.
Thank you. Oh, I'm a vegetarian. Wait, it's not a moral thing. Oh, David, honey, put half of those back. Honestly, I try and keep his cholesterol down, and then he just goes and does this.
Those eggs are from Judith's farm. I'm sure they'll be real good for your boy.
Oh, we've read about how much cholesterol there is in eggs.
I personally think they're really good.
Thank you.
I didn't mean it.
Sarah, you haven't met Sandy yet, have you?
She's new here. Another outsider.
Sandy Barlow, this is Sarah Jenks.
Hi.
You two should have lots to talk about.
So, you're Sarah. I've heard so much about you. Uh-oh. Did you just move here?
About three months ago.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I don't get out much. I'm a little busy with these guys.
I can see how.
Hi there. Why don't you sit down?
Oh, no, I don't want to intrude.
Oh, don't be silly. Please, sit down. This is my mother and father-in-law, Sandy Barlow.
Sandy.
Willa and Sam Jenks.
Sandy. Nice to meet you.
So where's your family?
Oh, I'm single. But I love children.
So why did you move to Tate, of all places?
I guess I just like to keep moving. Hey, you know, I do taxes. Accounting.
We moved here because we had to get out of California. I have earthquakes, floods, riots, fires, famine, locusts.
Flaming toads, moving stars.
Actually, my husband grew up here. He thought it would be a nice place for us to raise our kids. Oh, this is my husband. This is Paul and Ivy and David. This is Sandy Barlow.
Nice to meet you.
Wow, what a nice family.
You having fun?
Hey, you know, I got some toys y'all might like. Maybe I could bring them by.
How about this afternoon? 4 o'clock?
Yeah.
Great. We live right down the...
I already know. We're practically neighbors.
Well, terrific. I'll see you then.
Okay.
Hey, Benji.
With a short skirt.
She wears a real good too.
Oh, sick.
Hey, David, take this. Put that other stuff away, please.
Okay.
Maybe we should call him.
Just kind of caught your interest, hadn't she?
Well, I haven't exactly been overwhelmed by the local hospitality.
Perhaps. Maybe if you tried a little harder to get to know people around here.
Sure. I could join the Stitch and Bitch Club. They make the cutest little drink coasters out of these hog's ears.
What about this?
Living room. Well, better late than ever.
She's having dinner.
No.
Hey, you guys, go wash up. We're gonna eat soon. Come on in.
Are you sure?
Yes. Kids, come on in and say hi.
Hi, you found us.
Here you go.
What do you say? Thanks. Sandy brought this for you.
Just a little something.
Why don't you go play?
Ivy.
Shay. Why don't you make yourself at home?
Oh, thank you. I'm sorry I'm late.
It's okay. Can I get you some ice tea?
Sure.
So did you have fun at the picnic?
Yeah. What did you think of the band? Ray. So, LeVon tells me you just moved out here from Berkeley. Must be quite an adjustment coming up here.
I'll let you know as soon as I adjust.
Yeah, I lived in a couple big cities myself. I prefer the country, though. You know, clean air,
flies, dust, mud. You know, you need a farmer with a tractor to get you out when you get your car stuck. And believe me, you will get your car stuck.
Bless us, Lord, for these are gifts which we are about to receive. From thy bounty, may God provide for the wants of the poor, and may the souls of the faithful according to the mercy of God rest in peace. Ivy.
Thank you, God, for our dog, Rumi, Mom and Dad, Grandpa and Grandma.
That's very sweet, Ivy. David.
Dear God, thank you for helping Mom to be such a good farmer.
Thank you, God, for our new friend, Sandy. Do you want dressing?
I mean, I just need a little more time, and then I don't have to keep bothering you.
Is your welfare check?
Thank you. Kristen, you are so amazing.
Well, I'll tell you, it wasn't easy with all these cutbacks. I'm not sure how many more of those you'll be getting. How's the accounting business going?
Well, frankly, a lot slower than I had hoped. I mean, I got the sign and the stationery, but it always takes time to build up a good clientele, you know?
Well, any other prospects?
Oh, I think so. Yeah, a very promising one.
Morning, Sandy. What are you doing here?
Thought maybe a working man might like a fresh Bismarck or a French cruller.
Ooh. You don't mind if I do. So what's up?
Came by to see Sarah.
She's probably right inside. Are you okay?
It's my aunt. She's got this condition. It's called supraventricular tachycardia. She's not very old. It's just every time she gets an attack, I don't want to lose her.
See? This, and then you want to put the four wheels on. You need to put the big wheels at the back for sure, so that it doesn't fall over.
Keep an eye on your sister, okay?
Okay.
Sarah tell you about her heart?
No. Don't tell me that she has a heart condition, too.
She got the same damn thing.
Well, well. Hi.
Hey. Donuts, you want one?
They're good.
We're trying to cut down. Y'all ever slaughter those sheep? I love mutton.
Well, we could sell you one.
Maybe we could barter something.
I suppose we could work something out.
She burned herself on
the wildfire! Oh, my God. It's going to be okay. Mommy's going to take care of it, all right?
All right, David.
I didn't think that she'd come in.
Should we put something on it?
Yeah, I'll call her.
David,
settle down.
All right, all right. David, I need you to relax, all right? It's going to be all right.
Really sorry.
Okay.
Oh, this is really bad. We got to get it right
out. Okay, I'm going to drive. I'm going to make this all right. Okay, David, you come with us.
I'll stay here with David.
Sorry. I want to go with you.
Are you sure? Really?
Sarah,
go.
Let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
All right?
It's fine.
Go. That was scary, huh? She's going to be okay. Come here. Come on. Come sit with your Aunt Sandy. Come on. You know, you can call me that. Aunt Sandy.
I want to watch TV.
Not until you say Aunt Sandy. Come on. Aunt Sandy or no TV?
Aunt Sandy. Okay.
You know, you should part your hair on this. Kids. Hey, Aunt Jessie.
Hi.
I'm in Tate now. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's me. Always on the move. Listen, I was wondering, do I have any money in that old savings account of mine?
Oh, well, Sandy, I thought I did.
Well, do you think you could advance me some anyways? Because I'm running kind of low. Well, if you want to be that way about it, fine. Then I'll just come back and see what I can dig up. No. How does that grab you? I really appreciate it.
Is she gonna be okay?
It's a serious burn, but I think it'll be all right.
Your mommy takes good care of you, doesn't she?
And away we go.
I think you're the bravest girl I know.
I think she deserves a lollipop, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe you should get it. Can't
believe that. This is her 14th emergency this year, and we're worried about cost containment.
You know, I don't think that we can afford those braces for David. Mm-hmm. Did you register Ivy for kindergarten in the fall?
Could you please just not talk right now?
Forget it.
Hello? What? No, I'm sure it's okay. It's probably just coyotes. Right. Yeah, Paul will be right over. Yeah, okay. Bye. That was Sandy. She says she has wolves at her place and she's scared.
And why didn't she just shoot him?
She probably doesn't have a gun.
Do I?
Mm-hmm.
Bummer. And what would be in it for me?
It'll be extra sweet when you get home.
Oh, darling. You're already extra sweet.
And I like even better.
Ooh, that's a deal. It's a deal. Just don't start it without me.
My hero.
You need to tie the cans down, though, because otherwise the coyotes get at them.
Oh, I will. Yeah, I think I got some rope in here somewhere. So I'm real sorry for bothering you.
No bother.
Do you want a drink?
No, actually, I'm not much of a drinker. If everything's okay, I'm going to...
Oh, well, you just got here. I just hate being here by myself. Makes me want to eat. Sometimes I feel fat.
Are you not fat?
Are you sure? Do you won't mind if I have...
No, you go ahead.
Okay. Coffee? Nothing? You know, you and I have something in common. We both love someone with a heart condition. If you ever need a shoulder to cry on.
Well, I appreciate that. I do have to go. You know, if they come back, you just give us a call again.
I will. Thank you. It's good knowing you're so close. Bye. Well, fixed?
Well, nothing there, darling.
You probably scared me.
Yeah.
I saved you a place.
I guess I'm just tired.
It's okay.
Wait, come here.
This is gonna make a nice warm sweater. I think you look beautiful. Come on, up. Can I get some lunch?
Sure.
You think Dad approve of that bundle?
Nice job, Mom. You missed some big spots.
Come on, I'll race you to the house.
Hey, wait up for me. I can beat you. Mom, are you okay? Oh. Mom! Dad! Mom fell down! I can't wake her!
Dad, take her.
Next time, let Paul get somebody else to do his farm work for him. At least until we get your heart condition under control.
It feels fine right now.
Supraventricular tachycardia is serious.
Can you say that 5 times fast?
Every spell puts more strain on your heart. We don't want to make Paul a widower in 10 years.
If I move any slower, I'll be dead.
Fast lane's not an option for you. You've got to slow down. Rachel, when can I go home?
Now.
What are you doing here?
I got something real serious I need to talk to you about.
Honey, who is it?
All right, Sarah's just resting up a bit. I'll be right back. You just make yourself at home.
Hey, darling, Sandy's here.
I'm old.
So, what's up?
I'm in kind of a jam.
Sit down. What kind of a jam?
Financial. Is there any other kind?
Remember, I told you about my Aunt Jessie. They want to do a double bypass, and the hospital needs a $6,000 down payment by next Wednesday.
That's a lot of money.
I was thinking that maybe I could borrow it from you. You know, just until I get my feet.
Oh, Sandy, we don't have that kind of money.
Are you kidding?
I mean, a house like this, the land, the equipment. I mean, the tractor alone is worth $6,000.
You don't understand. We don't own the land.
And the bank owns this house.
Yeah, any equipment for that matter.
You could co-sign a note, right?
Sandy, we've got 6 mortgages on this place already. They won't let us sign anything. You know, some of the hospitals I've worked for have done things gratis for people who can't afford to pay.
Not this hospital. You know, I thought you, of all people, would understand what she's going through. I mean, she may not make it. She's very weak.
All right, Cindy. We are very sorry about your situation, but we can't help you.
I see. I get it. It's not your problem. Paul and Sarah and your perfect little life.
Wait a minute, Sandy.
No, you just forget it!
All right for you, Missy.
I don't know where to begin exactly.
Try. Just spit it up.
Well, I have this friend. What do you do if you see kids that are being abused?
You can tell us. I mean, we deal with child abuse here.
You have personally?
Our department does. I do.
Mm-hmm. What happens to me? I mean, I just want to make sure.
Oh, no, don't even worry about that. There are laws that protect anyone that brings attention to abuse.
Well, that helps, I guess. It's just, I'm so worried about these kids.
Okay, well, tell me about it.
Okay.
Winning.
Okay.
Now, once you've entered the numbers into the debit side, then compare those with the numbers in the credit side. Just don't reverse the numbers. Anybody for more rocket fuel?
Oh, I'd float away.
Did any of y'all hear about Sarah Jenks' little girl, Ivy, burning her hand?
Yeah, I heard about that. I was kind of surprised that a 5-year-old could get a hold of a waffle iron.
Yeah, well, I was there. I'm afraid that it didn't look accidental to me.
Sarah would never do that. Joni at the hospital said she's there with those kids all the time.
Yeah, well, what do you expect? They're vegetarians. Can hardly expect to raise healthy kids on a diet like that.
You know, poor David calls me Aunt Sandy. That is because I am always sitting with them when she is off running around doing who knows what. You know, I get the feeling that they are afraid of their mother.
You know, I seem to remember seeing her yank his arm outside the market the other day.
Yeah, but that was to keep him from moving into traffic. I mean, that's not child abuse.
Actually, they call it Munchausen by proxy. It's when you make your child sick or injure him just so you can get the attention.
Well, what are we gonna do? Maybe we should talk to her.
I don't think we should talk to her. I mean, the folks at social services are trained for that sort of thing. They would talk to her if we could just convince them. Maybe we should all just go right down there and tell them the whole thing.
Couldn't we just, like, write something down?
Yeah. We could all sign statements.
I hadn't thought of that. Maybe we should sign something. I mean, we would be doing it to help those poor kids.
Miss Taylor? I've got an update for you.
Oh, Kristen, come in. What have you learned?
Well, I checked the hospital's emergency records, and she uses the emergency room like it's a second home. And one of the complaints says that she's faking a heart condition.
Miss Taylor, it's the DA on 2.
I'll talk to him in a second. Tell me about the kids.
I understand there's physical abuse.
I'm sorry, it's George.
Get a message, Maura. Talk to friends, neighbors, teachers. This kind of case can really blow up on us if we don't move fast. Try to get statements by tomorrow. Good job, Kristen.
Miss Taylor, you know that I haven't actually completed my field training yet.
Oh, nothing like learning by jumping in with both feet. You'll do fine. You can put them on now, Maura. Go.
All right, you ready? Okay. Big breath out. Big breath in. There you go.
I want to go back there.
Back where?
To the church. I don't like that Sandy. And she's always asking questions about you and Dad.
David, you don't have to go anywhere you don't want to go, okay? All right, go to bed. I love you.
I love you too.
I'll come peek in on you later.
Okay.
It's Sarah Jenks. I just wanted to let you know that David won't be there tomorrow.
Oh, I hope nothing's wrong.
It's his asthma.
Oh, dear, I'm sorry.
I'll say a prayer.
Wait, can you hold on 1 second?
What are you doing out of bed?
I didn't kiss Dad goodnight.
Why, I oughta. Oh, I'm sorry about that, Levon.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
What do you think of Sandy Barlow?
Oh, the woman's a saint. Wish she organized our prayer group, and she helps out in Bible school and in the choir. I don't know how we ever got by with
her. Why? Oh, I was just wondering. I gotta go.
Oh. Okay, thanks for the phone call, and good luck.
What was all that about?
David, he hates Bible school. He doesn't want to go back there. He says that Sandy keeps asking him questions about you and I.
You know, that boy's got good sense. I don't want her around him anymore.
Whoa, don't stop.
She got mad at him because he was getting out of bed. I mean, if he's sick, why get mad?
Well, and they say that asthma's related to emotional problems.
Right.
Do you suppose any of these people might be home right now?
Well, you might find LeBon at the church. She helps her husband, Reverend Mike, on Wednesdays.
How did you know to write all this detail?
Just a hunch. I mean, we just wrote the truth.
The truth is, Miss Hadley, I wasn't there.
But I was, and she could have dislocated his arm. She tugged so hard.
So, you're convinced that...
I'm not convinced it's abuse. But I guess it's worth looking into. I mean, that's why I signed it.
How long have you known Sarah?
Since she's been here. What, about 2 years? She doesn't really fit in. But that's not a crime, is it?
Not all by itself. No.
Oh, Alice, remember, Ivy likes the crust cut off. Yeah. And try and get some vegetables into her, okay?
I will. Don't worry about us. We'll be fine.
Hey, David, how about some sushi?
They don't have sushi in this town.
Well, then let's go see a movie.
They don't have movies in this town either.
Well, then, we'll just have to go to the
But again? Oh, he's fine, Sarah. He'll grow out of it. You just have to keep on top of it, which you're doing.
I come here too often, don't I?
Oh, no, better safe than sorry. Besides, I enjoy the company.
Why don't we go get some Italian ice cream?
Oh, fat chance in this town. I'll see you later. Bye.
Bye. Remember every day after school?
Yeah.
I had to have my espresso, my double espresso with a little lemon. Oh, boy, do I miss that.
I remember how every day after school I'd get those little chocolate cookies that had the swirls. Wait, with white chocolate. What?
Look, yeah, somebody must be in trouble.
Look.
David.
What's happening, Mom? Why are they here?
David, we need to go in the house.
Mrs. Jenks?
What's going on? Are Paul and Ivy all right?
We're here for the children. We appreciate your full cooperation.
What?
I'm Kristen Hadley from the State Department of Social Services. We've had 4 complaints.
What? What do you mean complaints?
What do you mean you're here for the children? Ivy, I want you to come with me.
What's going on? Mrs. Jenks?
Are you David? Is that David Jenks?
Who are you?
Department of Social Services. Who are you?
I'm Alice. I'm the babysitter.
Alice, we've had some reports.
What kind of reports?
Listen, have you seen any signs of abuse or neglect of these children?
What? No, what, are you kidding? Is this a joke?
Miss, step outside, please.
Paul, get to the house right away.
They're trying to take the kids. Paul, hurry!
Get off the radio, now.
No, this is my radio. This is my house. These are my
Let's
children.
Talk too long.
David, go with me. David!
I need to ask you some questions, okay? Now I need to know. Does Mommy hit you?
What are you saying?
Now, we need you to pack for those kids.
No. Who gives you the right to come in here like this?
The state and the county, ma'am.
Under whose authority? Social Services.
Well, I want you off my property now.
Where is she taking my daughter?
Yes!
Ivy!
Ma'am! Hey, hey, hey!
Paul, no one's accusing you of anything.
What are you talking about, Bill? Who's accusing you of what?
We have reports that your wife has been abusing these children.
I'm sorry, who the hell are you?
Social services.
And who told you that?
We can't give out that information.
Well, it's the wrong information. Wait a second here. Wait, and it's...
David? Certain things have come to light. Very often, the husband is the last to know.
Do you folks have any firearms?
You better take our gun if you want to get in here.
Calm down, Donna. That's not going to do it. Billy? Billy, what are we talking about here?
We've got a foster home ready.
You got a foster.
You have a...
Daddy, I don't want to go.
Billy, these are our kids.
Paul, don't make it any worse than it is. I guess we could take them to your folks, right, Miss Hadley?
Sure.
The only abuse that has ever happened here is what you're doing right now, and I want you to understand something real clear. If a hair is harmed on either one of their heads, I'm gonna come after you.
They'll be fine at your folks, I promise. Mrs. Jenks, the law gives us the right to protect the children.
Oh, no, Sarah, Carlin, relax. Relax. Hey, take a deep breath. Take a deep breath, you gotta relax.
It's gonna be pain.
Come on. Sit down. Now you have to calm down. Take a deep breath. Slow down.
Okay.
We're gonna fix this, all right? You've gotta slow down.
Give you a loan so you have the state take our kids away? What kind of insanity is that?
Listen, I didn't do anything. Honest. Did someone say that I did?
Let me ask you something.
Paul?
Why? Why would you do something like that?
I am sorry about your kids, but you are talking to the wrong person.
Let's just get out of here. Let's go.
Yeah.
No one is going to take your word over ours.
Yeah, I'd like to report an assault. Sarah and Paul Jenks.
Okay. And when will that be done?
How do we get him back?
I'm going to have to call you back. Have a seat.
No, thanks. We'll stand.
I guess you were looking for the short answer.
Lady, we want any answer you got.
You took our babies away. The least you can do is tell us what we need to do to get them back.
Mrs. Jenks, you will have to take this psychiatric exam.
Why?
Do you think I'm crazy?
No, I didn't say that.
But I bet Sandy Barlow did.
Oh, she's conning you, lady. Can't you see that?
I've got you booked in tomorrow morning at 9:45.
Keeping our babies overnight.
Sorry. This is wrong. So wrong what you're doing.
That would be a...
What?
Nice surprise.
Shouldn't be here. How can anyone accuse me of child abuse? My children are my life.
Doctor, I don't know if you know this, but my wife has a heart condition. She risked everything to have those kids. Why do you think she'd want to hurt it?
Paul, maybe you should wait outside.
Well, shall we start?
Grandpa, how long are we staying here?
Oh, I don't know, David. You'll be going home soon enough. Mom and Dad just have to straighten out a few things, that's all.
What kind of things?
Grown-up things. Hey, I got an idea. How would you like to take a ride on the tractor?
Nah.
How would you like to drive it?
All right.
I'll teach you how to be a real farmer.
She can go.
Good. You think she's crazy? Huh? Anything in there say abuse to you?
No, sir, but...
Good, then I tell you what, you tell them that.
Let's just get out of here.
All right. Because this should have never happened.
Oh, my babies, I am pumping.
Oh, I missed you, Mrs.
Come here, you. How's my big fella, huh?
Do we get to stay here tonight?
Of course you do, honey. You live here.
Why don't they do that?
I don't know.
We don't know.
No, but they're not going to do it again. Promise?
Hey, listen to me, David. This is America, all right? They can't just take your kids like that.
That look.
Can't believe Sandy Barlow would do this because the kids wouldn't give her a loan.
Sarah's not like everybody else in town. We've known that from the start.
Well, that's no excuse to accuse you. Somebody else must have been involved. Maybe I'll go in town and talk to the folks.
That make you feel any better?
Depends on what I find out.
Well, I think we should be pleased. Social services clearly thought those kids should be taken out of that house. But I heard they got them back yesterday.
Yeah, well, that's only provisional. I mean, they could lose them again over the slightest incident.
There's not going to be any slightest incidents. Is it true that some of you have been accusing my daughter-in-law of hurting her kids? Huh? Because if you have, there's no truth in it. And it's downright mean, and it's cruel. It's the worst kind of gossip. Anybody spreading it ought to be ashamed.
Well, of course he is going to take that position. And he's her father-in-law.
Some moms feel David was afraid of his mother at Bible school.
Sarah? Afraid of Sarah? That's ridiculous.
I have an obligation to take suspected child abuse seriously. That's the law.
I really don't want to get anybody in trouble. I just want to understand this. You see, we pay pretty close attention to our kinfolk, and we've never seen any evidence of child abuse.
Well, sometimes it takes training. I think maybe Paul and Sarah would profit greatly from therapy.
Well,
we get them in therapy, I think everybody's going to feel a lot better. Paul, Sarah, the children.
And the state, right? Do you have any kids, Miss Hadley?
No.
Well, it hurts. Losing your kids. Even for one night. It hurts.
I'm sure does, sir.
When a young man...
Boy, we sure made a big mistake moving here.
Well, I think Grandma would have a different opinion on that subject. She sure likes having those kids around. Well, Sarah, I don't know if you and Paul are gonna make it as farmers, but I do know that you are a darn good mother.
Do you really think so?
Oh, I don't think so. I know so.
You better get out of here before I get emotional or something.
Well, Sarah, why have you not been emotional?
It may not look like much on the face of it, Your Honor, but
My problem is I don't see any proof. You don't even have preponderance of evidence.
I think the deputy could tell you something worth considering about the gun.
Deputy Boyd?
Well, when I asked her if she had any firearms, she, said yes.
That's inaccurate, Your Honor.
Her exact words, Your Honor, were, "You better take it if you want to get out of here alive."
Is that true?
Yes, sir.
It's clear we're dealing with an unstable woman who's a danger to her children. I recommend getting them out of there before any more serious damage occurs.
Don't let go.
Don't let go.
Don't let go.
He's gonna win.
I'm just saying. I don't want to smile.
Sometimes things just ain't bad and you'd like to run away. Okay, be serious. Sometimes you put up a fight and you make sure to stay. I'm feeling like I never did before, like there's nowhere safe to play. I'm feeling like the life I planned for myself has been ripped and torn away. But you lift me up, make me feel like the rise above the pain.
It's in their best interest to be removed from their mother.
Make me feel I'm not winning this crazy game.
Steady right there. Keep it level?
Yeah.
Done this before, haven't you? Okay. Time to hold it tight.
Okay. Daddy!
Oh, no. I mean, you're just kidding me.
You can't do this to us again.
These kids aren't going anywhere.
What is that? What is that?
You said we never have to do this again.
Okay, honey, I didn't know about this. Wait a minute.
You lied. I'm not going.
That's all I'm here. I'd appreciate it if you not make a scene.
I don't want to go to jail.
You're going to come with Mama. You're going to come with me.
No, you're not going to take the kids.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry, too. You're not taking those kids.
Mr. Jennings, we have a court order.
I don't care what you got. You're not taking those kids.
What's going on here?
We've got a court order, sir.
Wasn't there supposed to be some kind of a hearing? Nobody told us anything. You said they could go into counseling.
Well, they haven't, have they?
This is Gestapo tactics, Billy.
I would advise you not to threaten us, sir. Deputy Boyd?
Wait!
You can get the kids back once your wife takes a psychiatric exam.
I already took one. I passed it.
Well, we need a more thorough one.
Why can't the kids just stay with us?
Yeah. It worked out all right last time.
The court decided. This will be longer than one night.
So?
We already have a foster home. Deputies?
Before you take those kids, I want you to check them out completely. Any marks? Any bruises? And I want a signed statement on what you find.
I don't know if I can do that.
Well, you do it. You won't take them.
Okay, Sam.
Billy?
Hang on.
No.
Sarah. Okay. Sarah, listen to me. Sarah. We got no choice. There's no sign of any abuse, man.
Abuse can be psychological, too.
You don't have to tell me that, young lady.
I love you, Pumpkin. We're gonna make this all right.
You're gonna be okay.
David, I want you to take care of Ivy, okay? She's littler than you. And you are a family. You remember that.
You can't just come into your house and take your kids and not even tell you why.
Mommy loves you, no matter what. No matter where you are, okay? Mommy loves you. Mommy loves you.
Daddy!
Mommy loves you.
Come on, David.
Hello?
Hi. Come on, you're just in time for supper. Sit down.
Brenda, this is David, and this is Ivy. Children, this is your foster mother.
I'll be right back.
Well, I think you're gonna like it here.
We've gotta feed the body before we nurse the soul. Go ahead, eat.
Why did I ever move here? I don't belong here.
Don't do that.
You said country life is so peaceful, so safe. Neighbors are decent, helpful. It's a great place to raise kids.
You're gonna make me get your pills.
Nobody.
You have to
lifted
stay
a finger. Nobody said a word, not even the church.
You can't let this eat you up.
Eat me up. They have our children, and we don't even know where.
We're gonna get them back. Hey. Hey. We're a team, you and me. I need you. We're gonna get those kids back.
How? We're fighting the law.
Well, I think it's about time we got the law working for us.
So, have you ever abused your kids?
Never.
You spank them?
Sometimes, not often.
Mm-hmm. On the bottom or other places?
You know, Sarah, we don't need him. We'll find somebody else.
Wait.
No.
Mr. Carter, they say that you have daughters.
Five.
Both of you ever spank them?
Sometimes, not often. If I took your case,
I would investigate the truth of everything you tell me. Can you stand up to that kind of scrutiny?
We got nothing to hide, Mr. Carter.
Let me tell you something about child abuse laws. They're designed to protect kids. The state doesn't have to prove that you're guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. You have to prove that you're innocent. That's the law.
They want me to take a psych exam. I already took one.
You have got to take that psych exam. And I'm going to get those kids back with their grandparents.
Are you saying you're going to take our case?
That was some slick lawyer the kids hired.
Yeah, well, let's just hope he's slick enough to put an end to this nonsense.
It's not fair. I want to go home.
Why do we have to sleep here? I miss Mommy. Well,
let's go have the pie and watch the video.
I'll see you later.
Where are you going?
Oh, it's that damn little import of Sarah's. It broke down again. I don't know why she doesn't buy a real car.
Stop complaining and go fix it.
I'm going.
See you later, Dad. Thanks for the truck.
Hurry back. You can help me fix this thing.
Hey, darling, it's not going to be that bad. Maybe I'll just shut up.
Yeah.
This test is designed to ask you the same question over and over.
You mean to trap you?
The idea is to help you, Sarah.
Help? Like they're helping my children? Can we just do the test, please?
Sarah, I'm not here to judge you.
You can lock me away in a crazy ward if you don't like my answers and... Let's just start the test, please.
Yeah, I'll be right there. Thank you. Sarah Jenks just set the church on fire. The fire department will be here in a minute.
Oh, my gosh. Great. Do you prefer to A, read a book, B, read a magazine article, C, listen to the radio, D, listen to a record? What does this have to do with my children?
Well, no one question covers everything, but if you answer them all, then a pattern emerges.
What are you doing?
It's part of the test. We want to see how you appear, you know, nervous, calm.
I shouldn't be nervous. How I do here determines if I'm going to get my children back. Wouldn't you be nervous?
I understand you were hospitalized before, when you were 12.
How do you know about that? Turn that off.
I can't do that, Sarah.
Well, it doesn't have an off switch?
The purpose is to determine if you...
The purpose is to make me out to be crazy so that you can take my children away for good. Well, I am not crazy. Take me home.
Oh, Sarah, that's bad news.
He's trying to make me out to be crazy so that he can lock me up.
Hey, Sarah, did you finish that test?
I can't pass that test, Paul. It's designed to make you fail.
Thanks, Marge.
So, some say Sarah started the fire at the church.
Well, they don't have prints, but I wouldn't put it past her.
She's agitated.
You know, I think it's disgusting how people want to be the center of attention all the time.
Even to the point of arson. Hi. I'd like a loaf of whole wheat, please. Bread. I didn't do it. I was at Glenwood's hospital when the fire broke out. It's on record there.
Glenwood's is a mental institution.
You know what?
You know, I think on top of everything else, she is delusional.
The ways of man are filled with pain and sorrow, but we lift our voices in song and carry on.
Holy, holy, holy.
Going to church today. So Mama always takes us.
Well, Grandma doesn't feel too good.
What about you?
I don't feel too good either. There's other ways of talking to God.
I know that.
Hey, give this a try.
Thanks.
What was all that about?
Oh, he just wanted to know why we weren't going to church.
You didn't tell him.
No, I'm not going to tell him that nobody at church stood by us.
Miss Taylor? I think the judge is wavering in the Jinx case.
The Williams child died this morning. Cerebral hemorrhage. If you think the Jinx kids are abused, you stay with it.
You can count on me.
Sonny, I think you're enjoying this
one. I don't get it. And child abuse. And now they're trying to say you're crazy.
Keep changing the rules.
Yeah. You know, I don't think they're going to be satisfied until they got those kids for good.
Thank you.
that you don't hate me.
I don't know what makes you tick, lady, but I don't like it.
Well, maybe you would if you got to know me a little better. I don't buy it.
Yeah, neither do scorpions. See, they sting.
Listen, I am really sorry about what you're going through. You don't deserve to suffer. I mean, you're a terrific father, a wonderful man.
And you are a real piece of work.
Are you aware that Sarah was institutionalized when she was 12?
So?
You didn't know, did you?
And you listen to me. I want you to stay away from me and my family. Do you understand that?
She makes nuisance calls to Sandy Barlow's every night, all hang-ups.
Sarah doesn't make those calls. Put a tap on her line if you want to. Just please stop making these ridiculous and unfair accusations. She started a fire in her church. Now, how ludicrous can you get, Your Honor? Please. Please, this case is built on nothing but innuendo and falsehood.
Sarah Jenks has well established that she can be violent. The way she threatened Sandy that led to us seeking a protection order.
A protection order that was vacated, Your Honor.
Doesn't mean she didn't threaten.
No, what it means is that you were unable to prove it, just as you've been unable to prove everything else in this case.
Fact. Deputy Boyd here wrote that when he took the kids away from their house, there was not one mark on either of them. Fact. We have proof that Sarah does have a heart condition. I don't know. Maybe it's irrelevant to you, but you know, in this country, we still have a document called the Constitution.
Counsel,
you should read it.
Please. The fact is, she just last week walked out of a court-appointed evaluation at Glen Woods. That's not ancient history, and it's part of a disturbing pattern.
Judge, I've consulted an expert physician who feels certain that this may be a case of Munchausen by proxy.
Do you believe this?
Munchausen by proxy is abuse.
Munchausen
are not mutually exclusive.
Munchausen is far less common than physical abuse, and you know it. Sarah's own doctors say she does not have Munchausen, but I'll tell you what she does have. She has the normal instincts of a mother whose children have been taken away from her. She's angry, Your Honor, as any mother would be. A mom who feels that her kids are threatened will react like a lioness. It's biological. She's defending them.
Oh, please.
Well, maybe if you had kids of your own, you'd understand.
I will not tolerate ad hominem attacks. The state has not done its job. This whole case doesn't feel right to me. I want Sarah Jenks to go back to Glen Woods and finish that psychiatric evaluation. Is that clear?
So?
She's not the last go home, is he?
Well, not for a while, David. Your mom's gonna have to take a test first.
We'll think positive, kiddo.
I want to talk to that judge. I mean it. I don't want to leave here unless I can talk to him.
He can get this way.
No, it's absolutely out of the question.
We want to go home. We miss her. She's a real good mom. I mean, Grandma and Grandpa are nice. She's our mother.
Son, sometimes we have to decide things that make people sad. But we always try to be fair. Now, it's important that we get all the facts. Do you understand that? He will be hard to forget.
Sarah! It's bad.
want to see if the kids are okay.
We're going to Mom and Dad's.
Sarah, put on the jacket.
There's no time.
Whoa, back inside.
We gotta get out of here.
Forget about it, Sarah. There are live wires everywhere. We're not going anywhere until daylight. Help me with this fire.
Unbelievable. How am I ever going to fix this up?
Please, God, let the kids be okay.
Sarah, if Dad's house is all right, we're not going over. Today's not a visiting
day.
They
won't be watching us today.
Sarah, we're not going to be like them. You and I are going to be honest, all right? What did I tell you? Doesn't look too bad. Who's that? Oh, there you are, kids. There you are. Hey, come on, you.
There's something I need to tell you. I would have told you before, but I really didn't think it was that important. I wasn't trying to keep it from you.
It's about the mental hospital.
How do you know that?
Oh.
It was when I was 12. When Dad left us, I flipped out and ran away from home. And back then, when you ran away from home, what they did was either put you in a reform school or in a mental institution for observation.
Why would you keep that from me?
When I got home, my best friend wouldn't talk to me. I guess she thought I was crazy because of where I'd been. And I guess that I thought you might act the way she did. I know that's not fair.
No, it's not fair. You know, you can't leave me out of your life like that, Sarah. You know, what's in your past is in your past. We can leave it there, but... You're my wife, Sarah. You know, when you hurt, I hurt.
Have I told you that I love you?
Yeah. That's my girl.
I'm gonna go take that stupid psych exam again.
No, what if they twist it around on me?
Well, then I'm just gonna twist it right back. I want our kids. I think we need to get in out of the rain now.
Used to be the whole town would come out and help after a storm like this.
Yep. So a bunch of people over at the Johnson's place. You know, they haven't been here half as long as we have. Tell ya, we didn't get a single call either.
Hey.
Hey.
Do you know anyone from the 701 area code?
Why, should I?
Well, we've got about six calls to the same number. Look, this one's at 11:52 a.m.
Well, it counts me out, doesn't it? I'm out in the field that time of day.
David said that Sandy used to use the phone whenever we weren't around.
How come that doesn't surprise me?
I'm checking this out. So you're her aunt? Would you mind if I drove down there to talk to you? I won't take up much of your time. I'm leaving right now.
Thank you.
fence?
That's me.
I'm Sarah. I'm really sorry to bother you when you're not feeling well.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Your heart, the operation?
Oh. Sandy, Sandy, Sandy. Oh, she used that one. You know, she used to live right over there. George still does with the kids.
Sandy had kids?
Two. Oh, she didn't tell you that either. Come on around. Come on. You know, I called you once, but then I hung up as soon as you answered. I guess I just lost my nerve. See, like most of Sandy's relatives, and I raised her. I'm afraid of her. When I read about your kids, and hers were the same age when she left them, and in fact, they even look like hers. And George claimed child abuse against her. And I figured that's where she learned how to use the system. And use the system, she does.
Will you testify to this?
No. Sandy's too vengeful. She'd come after me. What she did to your life, that's a hobby with her.
Her ex-husband, George?
Yeah.
Is he home now?
Oh, no, he's at work, but he'll talk to you, too. She really shafted him. What?
It's payback time.
Are you ready?
Oh, that's the Colombian, isn't it?
I can't seem to drink the cheap stuff anymore. It doesn't agree with my sensitive nature.
Hi.
Sarah Jenks.
How are you?
I'm fine.
So are you going to pay for this?
What?
She wants you to think I'm kidding. Smart move using my phone to call your aunt. By the way, you owe me $43. She owes the hardware store $400.
I don't know what she's talking about. Sarah, you are insane. Judith,
you tried to prove that, didn't you? But actually, I found out that you're the crazy one. These are photos of Sandy's kids. She left them 4 years ago. Her ex-husband accused her of abuse and neglect. Look, you see how the boy looks like David?
She's making this up.
Somebody's making things up.
You know, before you go messing up other people's lives, you should stop and take a look at your own.
You know, I don't have to listen to this.
You gonna pay cash for this, Sandy?
You can just charge it.
Sandy, you already owe us $256.
She owes her attorney $8,000. She owes the pharmacy.
Look, Missy! Everybody here made up their mind about you a long time ago. So if you think that you could just waltz in here and wave some photos of some kids around, then you... Judith, I need those things.
I'm sorry, Sandy.
Well, how am I supposed to live?
Oh, you'll be fine. You'll just find somebody else's life to ruin.
Here are the medical reports confirming Sarah's heart condition and David's asthma. Here's a signed statement from the police confirming that there has never been any evidence of physical abuse. Here are recantations from every accuser with the exception of Sandy Barlow, who clearly has an agenda of her own. And here are the two psychiatric examinations certifying that my client is absolutely sane. Now, sir, short of a presidential decree, what does Sarah have to prove to get her family back?
Sarah? Sarah, I wanted to tell you in person that the kids are coming home.
Don't joke.
I never joke. The judge said they didn't prove the case.
Yes, I have ears here.
I did.
I'm sorry.
Well, Kristen is trying to stall. Is there any doubt? No. No, it's definite. The kids are coming home.
Well, I'm not going to sit here and wait for that dried-up prune to decide when she's sending my children home.
Sarah.
We've got enough cases.
What the hell is going on? I want my children back.
You'd have to know protocol to understand it isn't quite that easy.
Did you know that Sandy Barlow had the same allegations leveled at her when she abandoned her kids?
Ma'am, even if we have a complaint about abuse from a convicted murderer, we have to take it seriously.
I wasn't aware of any murder convictions. Yet.
What, are you threatening us?
Am I being too subtle?
No need to get hostile, Mrs. Jinx.
You take my children away? You tell me when I can phone them, when I can see them, and under what conditions? You may not know what hell is like, but if those kids are not there by the time I get home, you are gonna find out.
Look, I'm Kristen. Let it go.
You happy now, darling?
Very.
Oh, there you go. David, you just stay right here.
Hope we're not intruding.
Well, what's all this?
We brought them food. Mind if we join the party?
Well, we got kind of a, you know, family thing going.
Hank's bringing the strapping, but we've got 2x4s in Ed and Laura's truck, and Len's bringing the shingles that we need.
You.
Come on, girls.
Hey, Sarah.
We don't want to intrude. We just want to let you know that you've got some friends. Friends? Our friends didn't help get the kids back, did they? Sarah, it was like she hypnotized us. We saw everything through Sandy's eyes. I haven't slept since this whole thing started.
Me neither. I'm just sick about this. Sarah, I'm so sorry.
There's some iced tea on the table.
I've got a great recipe for cappuccino. Does anybody here drink that? Well, you do, Sarah. I've had it with you.
Sometimes.
Well, figures, the city slickers.
Sometimes things just ain't right and you'd like to run away. Sometimes you put up a fight and you make sure to stay. I'm feeling like I never did before, like there's so much more to say. Feeling like I could come for a while and I'm throwing all the weight. Cause you lift me up, make me feel not a thing will bring me down. You lift me up, make me feel only love all around.
Anyway, here's the recipe. So what's the deal with that fair next week? Is it like cows and hogs and things?
And quilts. And some of the best organic fruit you'll ever find. Laura and I have some entries in it.
We were going to enter a sheep.
Don't tell me. The one you gave Sandy?
Oh, no. She didn't tell you about that, did she?
We all gave to Sandy. Maybe we'll enter one next year.
Hmm? What'd you say?
I said, maybe we'll enter one of our prize-winning sheep next year.